Welcome to our educational academy. We enhance your subject knowledge, technical skills, individual personality, and makes you job ready.
Continuing the subject of digital marketing, today we are going to learn about website conceptualization. Before starting up the video, let's motivate each other by sharing the quote of the day, which says, "Pleasure in the job puts perfection in the work." So I request, do what you enjoy and enjoy what you do. Talking about the outline of the video, in this video we're going to learn about the components of website and about the website planning. In the previous video also we learned about website planning, but in the previous video we covered the various elements of a website. Now we are going to learn them more in detail in this video. So talking about the components of website, the first component would be the home page and the website template design. It is necessary to make sure have an attractive, functional and consistent appearance on your website. Unless until you don't have these elements in your website, people would get bored with your website or would get confused with your website. Next component for your website would be integrated site navigation, which provides clear and consistent access to your website. If your website doesn't have a proper navigation, people would get confused in your website and end up leaving your website. Now talking about the next component of website, which says look and feel of your website. The color of your website, the text you're using in the website, the graphic, as well as the function it provides. For example, if you're having a function of subscribe button in your website, all these components make your website more attractive. The next component which we're going to discuss is the logo. It is very important to have your logo to be displayed at a very appropriate place. Usually the logo is displayed in the left corner of each page of your website. Consider the example of Amazon. Amazon also having their logo on the extreme left corner. Next component would be the sitemap, to provide a list of all the pages on your website. Whenever you visit a website, there's a sitemap to it, which consists of all the elements that are included on a website. For example, if the website is having their product listed on that website, then they would always put the product list in the sitemap. Helps to structure the website more properly. Next component would be the web search features, allowing users to search the website for content relevant to their specific interest. Always make sure to have a search option in the website. For example, if a user is searching for any specific element in your website, he'll not keep on manually searching on the website for that specific element. Instead of having that search button in your website, allows a user to save his time. As now we have discussed the various basic components of a website, now let's learn about the pages of website, starting with the about page. The about page that includes a complete description of you and your company, your website or a company objectives, your name, address, phone number and email. It is very necessary to have an about page in your website, and that about page should be the front page of your website, because the about page would not give brief description about your website, just an overlook of your website with your objectives and your contact details, so that the user would be able to judge the website he is accessing right now is useful for him or her or not. Next component is the feedback. It is very necessary to have a feedback mechanism in your website that facilitates the customers to ask some queries about your products and services, as well as provide their feedback in case of any issue. Now talking about the domain name, which we have already discussed in the previous video. Domain name is your address on the internet, what people type in their browser to find you. You choose a word or phrase, for example, my website name, and an extension, for example, .com, .net, .edu to your domain name. Now talking about web hosting. Web hosting is the physical place where your website resides, which includes a computer known as server, as well as it is also defined as a connection to the internet and the technology that makes your website work. Now talking about website planning is the most important part of building a website. Before designing a website, it is necessary to do proper planning, as we do in the case of building a house. If you start building your house without giving a thought of planning, the house may end up into an uncomfortable dwelling. Therefore, for building a good website, proper planning is required. You need to understand the demographic of your audience in order to build your website so that you can build your website accordingly. It is necessary to build your website as per the audience of your website so that you can get the interest of your audience in your website. So the basic steps that help in planning a website, starting up, defining your target audience. First, you need to define your audience, whom you are targeting. Then only you're able to design your website. Unless until you don't know for whom you're designing your product or your website, you're not able to define the elements, the characteristics of your website accordingly. Then organize your concepts and materials as per the target audience which you have identified. Then you need to create a directory structure, also known as sitemap. Sitemap includes the structure of your website, what all your website holds. For example, if you're having a product catalog in your website, it is necessary to put that on a sitemap that yes, your site is having a product catalog under the category of products. Then you need to create a sketch of the pages you are intended to create. For example, if you are planning to have pages such as about page, product list page, contact us page, you need to sketch how you are going to structure your pages. Next step would be defining the design and refine the look and the feel of the website. Design should not be complicated, it should be very simple. Structure and the look of the website should be very contemporary, should be very attractive. So let me explain you this figure in order to make you understand more about the structure of a website. Starting up with the home page. The homepage of a website should include the About Us section, which talks about your company, the objectives of your company, followed by a sitemap. Sitemap defines what all pages that are included in your website. For example, company information page. Company information page would include a detailed description about your company, defining the vision of your company and the objectives of the company. Other page could include the archive of the company. Archive of the company defines the past news, the past events about the companies, as well as the current event and news of the company. Then we can also include a request information page where a user who's looking for some specific information could type his or her query in that page and the company can respond to his query. Other page that can be included in your website could be the product or service catalog. It is always recommended for the companies who are dealing into product and services to have a catalog posted on your website so that the customer could go through their product and services and able to find that whether the product and services are of his use or not. A website developer can also include a page called experience or testimonials in their website which describe the past experiences of their customers. It always recommended to have such pages in your website. Positive feedback would always get more customers to your business. The company can also have blogs in your website in which they can provide information related to their businesses. So that was all that to be included in a website. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you like this video, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel and share this video. Please comment down your queries in the comment section below, or you can email us at professorforhelp@gmail.com.